Alright, we're on the play. I'm going to keep this hand. It's missing a little bit of action, but we got interaction, so should be fine. I'm not going to be casting Phalanx of the Thing turn one. I'll probably cast Thought Scour and get a Steam Vents. Position's fine. Yeah, I'll let that resolve. I could cast Thought Scour in response, but I don't really mind if he takes a Thought Scour here. I'll just fetch a tap chuck land. Alright, so he did take Remand. I'm tempted to get Island. That's such an awkwardness from the deck. I want to get an island, but I can't cast Helix turn 2 unless I fire off my Mana Morphos, so. And I guess I would rather not have to. So I have to get Hallowed Fountain, then Mountain. Yeah, that works. Million Helix and a Sacred Foundry. And we drew Ascension. That's a good draw. Let's just hope he doesn't have Abrupt Decay if he's playing Jund. Alright, so he Thought Seized me, got my Elix out of my hand. We're going to cast Metamorphos for a blue and a red. Probably cast the other one. Drew Steam Vents, so yeah, we're indeed gonna cast the other one for a blue and a red. Like to use it. Blue, red. Drew another Ascension. I think I want to play it. Yeah, I want to play it. And then Steam Vents untapped. And then cast Thought Scour end of turn. And we'll have one active Ascension. Just need to find some card draw. Oh, no Maelstrom Pulse. Maelstrom Pulse, please. Alright, Liliana. That could have been a reason that I keep an Ascension in hand would have been Pulse, but they play more Abrupt Decays than play Pulse. Alright, well, Thought Scour in response. Yes, I'd like to use the ability. Discard an island. I wish we milled Faithless Looting there. Okay, well, we drew one. Almost the same thing. Put counters. We don't have Visions of Beyond in the graveyard. So, what I can do is I can discard. I don't have to cast the Elder Faithless Looting. I can just flashback one of them next turn to put the second counter. So what I can do here is discard Looting and Remand, cast Visions of Beyond, draw two cards. Try to go from there. Yeah, I think that's my line. Oh, I guess I have two Faithless Lootings resolving. Okay, then we'll keep a Thought Scour because that's going to put counter. It's going to put a counter on the second one. No, same targets. Yes. Serum Visions. I could fetch first. Let's see if I have targets left. 1, 2, 3 islands are gone. Mountain is gone. Sacred Founder is gone. 2 Sacred Founder are gone. So I literally have no target for this serum, for this Sculpting Tarn. So I'm gonna keep it in hand. Whatever. I don't think he has X Parasite in his deck to remove counters. We'll keep Serum Visions. Wait, am I not supposed to have two other copies? Alright, so I did. I basically misclicked. I thought it were asking me to put a counter, or that when I had to say yes or no, but it were actually asking me to put a copy on the stack. So, my bad. This card's Scalding Tarn, obviously. He discards Grim Flayer. And cast a Culligan's Command, bringing back Grim Flayer and having us discard his Serum Visions. Another one. Which we'll cast using this in case we draw Lightning Helix. From now on, I'm just going to say yes to everything. Okay. Drew a thing. Man can go on bottom. Serum Visions, always nice. Yes. Alright, Metamorphose is great because it's going to draw us a bunch of cards. Visions of Beyond is insane right now. And I need any Lightning Bolt to kill him. So I can Metamorphose, make basically infinite mana. I'll make at least probably like 3 blue, 3 red. I'll make, yeah, I think 3 blue, 3 red sounds right. Or maybe 4 blue, 2 red. Maybe white. I don't need to cast Helix this turn, I guess. So probably not white. I'll make 2 blue. Drew Floodstrand, which has no target. We'll cast Visions of Beyond. We're gonna draw 9 cards. So, have to be careful not to deck. I still have 1 Metamorphose left in my deck. Drawing it would be nice. I did draw it. Unfortunately, these Thingandairs are not haste. I can bolt for, I can actually just kill him right now. I can deal 18, yeah. Take the easy way. Yes. Same target. Nope. Yes. Same target. I wonder why it's at. It's not asking me now to put counters. Oh, I guess I don't have other lightning bolts in the graveyard. Nope. Nope. Yes, same targets. Says same targets. Nope. Same targets. Nope. And we got there. All right, well, that wasn't too complicated. Definitely less complicated than Storm. Pose board, we're on the draw, we're playing against Jund with Grim Flayers. Blood Moon is a reasonable card, but I think it's way worse against Jund and Junk, because it can actually use the red mana. I think explosives is an option. Path is an option. I think Fateless Looting is pretty poor. It's card disadvantage on its own, which we don't want against a disruptive deck. We'll board those out for, I think I'll just board in two path and explosives. Alright, so I'm going to keep this hand. Only one land, but we're on the draw. We have a Thought Scour, a bunch of cantrips in our deck, and we have a Lightning Bolt. So, in this hand, like, it gives him the hard choice of, does he want to take this Thought Scour in hopes that I never draw a second land, or does he take the actual good card in my deck, in my hand, which is Ascension? I think Thing in the Eyes could have been boarded out, however, he didn't really see it. I guess I milled it, so he could have seen it. It's pretty bad against Liliana. I think it's something we can keep in hand until we can actually, like, flip it the same turn. And then, like, use it to buy time by bouncing his creatures. Alright, so it does play Grim Flayer. I'm still gonna cast Thought Scour first. And then I probably Lightning Bolt here. Yeah, it's really tempting to keep Remand up for Liliana. I guess I could also play Thing in the Ice, and if he has Liliana, he's forced to minus two. He's forced to minus two, he connects with Grim Flayer, but then I can bolt the Liliana, Path to Exile, the Grim Flayer. Yeah, that's probably okay. If he doesn't have the Liliana, I think it's still pretty good. And obviously the best case scenario is he doesn't have a removal. Yeah, I guess Bolt is awkward here. Because he gets to trample for one, so he gets to activate it. So maybe I just don't even block, and then I try to flip it on my turn. But if I don't block, if he has Liliana, if this was just like a bluff, plays Liliana, minuses it, so it's kind of like the same thing. I block, he bolts. I think because two of my one mana cards are removals, flipping Thing in the Ice right now is just not that good. So I'm just going to block and don't really value flipping it that much. Alright, didn't have Bolt. Alright, so we did call. Goyf is a 5-6, so we're going to have to bat this for sure. Yeah, it's pretty sick because I can path and then Manamorphose, play Bolt, Vision of the Beyond, attack. We'll do just that. Get Island here. Play Manamorphose. And I have to choose, do I want to kill the Grim Flayer or deal three to him? If I kill the Grim Flayer, I attack for seven, he's down to nine. If I bolt him, he's down to six. So a single Thing in the Eyes is lethal, and two bolt effects are lethal. So I think I just bolt him. I don't really care that he gets back the Grim Flayer back in his hand. red. I cast this. And I cast Bolt on him. Thing in the ice flips. Attack for 7. Alright, so he had a Liliana. I don't know if he just drew it. Hard to say. Anyhow, let's just draw another Bolt and end this. Play Ooze. Alright, Ascension. Ascension is kind of awkward because both of our cards don't trigger it for now. I could just Elix the thing. I guess there's two creatures in the graveyards. I'll just take 2, Helix this. Yeah, Helix it, keep Remand up. Remand. I have the choice, do I Remand the Grimfeller, literally just a Scry? Because if he pluses first, can I have to discard Ascension if I want to cast a Remand, and it's just not that good because he can replay the Grim Flayer. So it's probably just better to slam the Ascension, discard a Remand, and hope to draw a cantrip that works well with Ascension. And he had Abrupt Decay. And Blood Moon? Weird. Okay, so he's playing Blood Moon Jun, I guess. So the list that was played by Raf Levy and Jeremy Dazani at Pro Tour, GP in France, the modern one. So they just play much more basics, basically. We'll discard Path, because we can never cast it again. It's funny, though, because Blood Moon is just not that good against us. We now have, like, we have our mana. I don't understand why he doesn't cast a Grimflayer. Maybe he's scared that it dies to a Bolt because it doesn't have... I guess he does have a Delirium. He has 4 types. That's weird. Works. We'll discard 1. Right, now decides to play it. We'll Remand. Oh, I guess I understand why he did that, because he couldn't replay it, but still, I think it's still better just play it and get my Remand out of there. Okay, so I have a Probe. I don't have another one in the graveyard. I have a Thoughtscour, and I have another one in the graveyard so that could be triggered. There's no point in casting the Probe for 2 life right away. So those 2 will be on top. And we'll pass. That's fine. He's gonna plus. Or does he have a card he wants to keep? Oh, that's smart. So he pluses. And in a response, cast a Culligan's Command to have me basically effectively discard my 2 cards. Then we draw Ascension, which we'll play. We have Thoughtscour on top, so we're pretty live. Just need to like not flood with not draw land with Thoughtscour. Draws an Ooze, which can eat 1 card. Him getting to 7 life is actually huge. So he put a Goyf and a Culligan's Command. No, just a Goyf in the graveyard. I could actually just target him with Thoughtscour at this point to stop him from drawing these 2 cards that he kept. Yeah, we'll do that. Yes, I'd like to put a counter here. Alright, we drew Helix, but we can't cast that. Yeah, that's one thing. I think. Oh, we fought. Okay, activate Liana, yeah. I think you probably have to board out some Helix against Blood Moon, or like even if you board them, if I board them myself, probably board out a few Helix. I can still cast it with Metamorphose, but it definitely gets worse. Down to two. And come on, Lightning Bolt. No, I can't. Oh, it's not true. It doesn't work. I need to draw a cantrip into a Lightning Bolt. And we did not get there. Alright. Game three. So I don't want to Blood Moons, for sure, even if I'm on the play, because he has something to deal with them. We're still not going to board out the Lightning Helix. I just don't have anything that's good in my sideboard anyway. I don't really want a bunch of Path in my deck. For the same reason that I won't be able to cast them. It's possible I want a few of the Fatal Slootings back. They're pretty good against Blood Moon. Can also be more careful with my Metamorphoses. Yeah, I'm going to play the same thing. I don't think Fatal Slootings is that good. If he doesn't have Blood Moon, it's just pretty bad against his general game plan. Well, that's no land. It's got two probes, but I don't want to take that risk. The hand doesn't even have Ascension. If it had Ascension, maybe I'd consider it just because it's the best card in the matchup. Alright, we'll keep this one. And we'll cast a probe. Don't really have to be super aggressive here, so I can pay mana for it. Alright, I'll draw a bolt. Plays in Christian, I think I'll take my remand. Took my bolt and we drew another one. So use Bloodstained Mire and Inquisition. Not sure if I want to remand the ooze or I just wait. It's kind of awkward to remand because then he can replay it later and have actual mana up to use it. I think I'll just cast a probe and keep my remand for later, for Liliana on turn 3 maybe. Drew Thoughtseize. Serum Vigilance is nice. Get Hallowed Fountain. Cast Serum Visions. I can keep one, I guess. I can keep both of them. Yeah, I can keep both of them for Ascension. Scavenging Ooze. We'll bolt that. And keep Remand up. It's probably going to Thoughtseize, take it. But that's fine. If he's doing that, he's not casting Liana. Alright, he plays Raging Ravine. It doesn't play Thoughtseize. Interesting. Plays, I guess he keeps Abrupt Decay mana up. So I know I have Thoughtscour on top. So I guess I Thoughtscour him. Because I want to draw it. I guess I don't necessarily want to draw it. Oh, I fetched, I think. Yeah, I fetched. I lost it. Okay, so I have an Ascension and a thing. He has a Thermionate, which I know, so it's probably not that smart. I can play. I'll go ahead and play Ascension. If he has Abrupt Decay, he has it. We'll hope to just find another one. Alright, that resolves. I'm going to pay life for this in hopes to draw a land or just a 1 mana card. He has another Terminate. Okay, interesting. And we didn't draw a land, so we're just going to pass. We have two Thinking Eyes, but he has two Terminate. I think I'll still cast them when I can, because it'll force him to just use a mana. Alright, he's going to Thought Seize my Remand, probably. Yep. Play Thing in the Ice. I'm gonna play both. So this turn he can't attack the Ravine because he has a Termin, I guess. I guess it doesn't have to. Could be punished if I chain a bunch of cantrips. I'll block. Yeah. That's unlucky. Inquisition hit nothing. Then he's gonna attack again. And now I have to decide, do I go around 3 or block? Because if I go around 3, I'm dead to Lightning Bolt. Which he may or may not have boarded out. I'll just block. I mean, it's gonna die to Terminate anyway, so. God damn it. Play it. Pass. Alright, he goes to town. At least he doesn't have a Lightning Bolt. And we drew 4 lands in a row. Or 3. Anyhow, no spells. So we die. Alright, well, we did play against 2 matchups that just end so quickly. Unfortunately, that's Modern, and I did like the fact that I could just kill Death Shadow out of nowhere. Boggles seemed like a bad matchup, but not in Thing in the Ice feels like I could have gotten out of there if I was quick enough. And this matchup honestly feels reasonable, not excellent, but I think it's reasonable. Pyromancer and Ascension, if he can stick, is so good. So I'm going to be playing a little bit more with it. I think it's quite interesting. I might try to change a few cards in it. There's a few sideboard cards I didn't really like. I think 3 Blood Moon might be too much. I think the deck maybe want like just one more card that's good against Black Green X. I felt like I wanted to like board out maybe Remand. Just have like a real good other card, source card advantage. Maybe like Ancestral Vision or something. Anyhow, I'll see you next week, and thanks for watching.